Jonah, after Nineveh repents, after Jonah goes around for 3 days to give the message of God to them, to repent, or in 40 days they would be destroyed, they truly repent. They put on sackcloth, they fast, and the king proclaims, you know, everybody needs to repent. Not even the animals should be eating or drinking. So when they repented, God forgives them, and they're not destroyed. You know, if something like that, you know, happened, the thing to do would be to be happy for them, right? But Jonah wasn't happy. Of course, he didn't want to go there in the first place, but forcefully, even being inside of the belly of a fish, he was brought there, then he had to go around for 3 days to preach to them, and when he did, he repented. He wasn't happy. So he tells God, Lord, didn't I tell you this even before I left? I knew this would happen. I knew if they repented, you would not destroy them. They would be saying, this is why I didn't want to come. Is that something someone should say? Probably not. But at the same time, while he says this, he confesses who God is. You know, he talks about God and he says, you know, God, you are a merciful, a gracious, a compassionate God. God who waits for a long time. God who does not want to destroy. God who relents. That's the kind of God he knew he was. That same God is the God that created each one of us. You know, this week I was reminded by one of my sons, actually. He's all into YouTube stuff. Any of you into the YouTube stuff? I'm not a whole big YouTube guy. He listens to all these, you know, people speaking and stuff. And he, when he finds a really good one, he sort of forces me to listen to it. So yesterday I ended up listening to this guy, and he was preaching, and he said, you know what kind of God we believe in? He said, if we were to compare the earth, it will be the size of a golf ball. You all know golf. Do you, any of you golf? Yeah, there are a couple of them. I don't golf, so I don't know. So, but I know that it's about this big, right? Maybe about 1.5 inches in diameter. If the golf ball, if the earth is the size of a golf ball, the sun would be about 50 feet in diameter. 15 feet wide, you know, that's the size it would be. I mean, it's huge. It could contain hundreds of thousands of golf balls in it. That's how big it is. Just the sun. They said, you know, there are other stars in the Milky Way, of which we know, one a little bigger than that, which is, it would contain about 1 billion, or actually 3 billion off ball size Earths. That's how big it is. 3 billion. How big is that? You can fill the Superdome. Do you know where that is? The Superdome. 3,000 times. That's how many Earths. Then he says there's another star bigger than that that we just found, which could contain over a quadrillion Earths. And how big is that? You can fill Texas 12-inch deep with golf-sized Earths if you were to compare. That's how big that star is. But that star is just one of billions of stars in the Milky Way. And the Milky Way is just one of billions of these constellations in the universe. And the God that I'm preaching to you today is the God that created all these things. all these stars. He's the one that not only created them, but also sustains them today and sustains your and my life today. And Jonah knew this. And Jonah knew that this great God who had created everything and sustains all life is also a gracious, compassionate God, a merciful God. That if we go to Him in person and say, Lord, I'm a sinner. I need your forgiveness. I need your compassion. I need you to touch me so that I can live a new, changed life. He knew that. That that's the kind of God he was preaching about. That's why he wasn't happy. That's why, you know, he didn't like it. Because he knew that if they repented, he would forgive them. You know, just as he forgave those people in Nineveh, he forgives us. And how does he do that? He made a great sacrifice about 2,000 years ago. He sent his one and only son, Jesus Christ. Some of you had children, right? Remember, I brought one of them, actually three of mine last week. One of them led the singing. If anyone asked me to give up one of them, I don't think I could. Of course, you know, once in a while, they drive me crazy, right? Three of them are teenagers, and my last one is getting there. She's in sixth grade, becoming a teenager. She started to not listen to me. But still, I love them. And because they're my children, I couldn't give them up. But the Bible says, God, while we were still sinners, while we were still his enemies, he sent his one and only son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross. He made his sacrifice so that we could have eternal life. That's the great news. That's the good news. I'm sure you heard this message tons of times. But you know what? Never get so scared. Never get cold. Because it's the good news. This great God is giving us this message again today because he knows that there is someone out there, one of you out there, I don't know how many of you, that still has not accepted this Jesus Christ he sent to die for us. Because he says that if we believe in him, if we trust in him, he gives us the gift of eternal life. It is a gift. We can't earn it. We cannot pay for it. There's no way to do it. It is so big and so great, so huge, that there's absolutely nothing we can do to earn it. You know, there are many people around the world doing pilgrimages, right? Walking thousands of miles, kneeling hundreds of miles, so they can get into something better. But you know what? None of those things will give you eternal life. None of those things. What they will do is they will help you to realize how weak, how great a sinner you are. I thought, you know, Amazing Grace is so fitting, isn't it? Amazing Grace, how, you know, your love, it's your love that changes him. You know, the person that wrote that song, he used to be a slave driver. He would get people and he would make them slaves. Then, you know, he realized that he was a sinner. He himself was a sinner. And he wrote that song saying, Lord, your grace is so amazing. So amazing. So great, great enough to save me. And I want to remind you today that he can be a great God to you, that merciful God to you, that gracious God to you, that forgiving God to you, if you would accept him.